Thank you for joining us today. I am happy to see you. Thank you for being good boys and girls. Welcome again for this new Sunday. Could you please welcome your friends and tell them it is now time for Sunday school. Are you ready to be there? Call them, say, my sister, my friend, it is time for Sunday school. And they'll be ready for you. Are you ready there? Please, hands together, eyes closed, head bow. As we pray, Lord our God, we thank you for this morning. Thank you for these boys and girls that have been so good. Thank you for the past week and bless us today as we start this lesson. We bless you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, and everybody say, Amen. Welcome again, your friends there who are watching us there, everyone out there. We miss you. We want to see you again. But time is coming. We shall be together again. God has been so good and faithful to each one of you, and today is another opportunity that God has given unto us. Are you ready to jump and praise with us together? Wonderful. That is very interesting. Now, before we go and do the praise and worship, we want to remind ourselves about what we learned about last Sunday. And last Sunday, one of the most interesting things we did, we talked about reaching out to the lost. Remember? Reaching out the lost. And there are three things we talked about last Sunday. You remember them? We talked about those wonderful boys out there, and we talked about three things. And number one, we talked about the love of God that he has showed to us. And we said we must go and reach out to those boys and girls out there. And two, we talked about the care we have for them. We must care for them. And number three, we talked about prayer. I hope this last week you had time to pray for them. I hope that was good. Wonderful. That was an amazing one. Now, today is another wonderful day. I know you're there. You'll be able to do it. And it will be wonderful and so good. Today, I want to call upon each one of you. And I want to welcome everybody wherever you are. Tell your friends and say, stand up. I want to welcome you to worship together. I want us to worship together. The Lord Jesus. Welcome everybody to worship together. We are going to worship together. That's an amazing. It was a wonderful time of the worship together, and God has heard us. And that is very good. Boys and girls, this is another amazing day that you don't need to miss. And I am happy that you have joined us. Now, today, we have another amazing lesson to talk about. Why do we need to reach out to those boys and girls out there? There are so many things that we can talk about. And it is one particular thing that makes us to reach out to those boys and girls. Having looked at what we did the other time, today we want to talk about four more other things why we should be able to reach out to those boys and girls. There is a particular one big thing that God does not like and makes God sad. Everybody said, very sad, and God gets worried about it. And when he looks about, he says, my boys and girls are not doing well. And God gets sad. Everybody say, Bambi, oh, sad. Have you ever been disappointed? And when you are disappointed, what happens? People get worried and they touch. They say, people are very sad. People are not happy. Things are not good. So there is one big thing that makes God sad. Can you guess? I wish you were near me. You would be able to guess it and see it. That is sin. Anybody who can remind us about that? Can you be able to remember? And now we are talking about sin. Sin is something we think, we say, we do, which does not please God. Up there, we are saying sin is something we think, we say, we do, which does not please God up there. And up there, when it is not pleased, God is not happy at all with us. And what happens? By the end of the day, when God is not happy with us, we cannot be able to enjoy the good things. Remember, in our creation story, the Bible says that when God was creating man and woman, you remember there was sun, there was moon, there was fish, there was God, there was darkness, there was lakes and rivers and water. God said his interest was to have man, to live together with man. However, man did not do well, and there are four things we are going to look out. Now, remember our main topic we are saying? Reaching out to the lost. And today we are saying, why should we reach out to them? What is the problem? That what has happened to them that we must reach out to them? One of the things, and we say, that third thing that makes God not happy, and that is sin. Now, what happens after you and me have sinned before God? The first thing that happens is that we are separated from God. Remember, man was created to stay together with God, but we are separated from God. Our friendship, our relationship with God is cut off completely. That's what happened when we sin. So you and me, we are supposed to be friends of God. Now, we must reach out to those boys and girls out there so that they cannot be able to be cut off completely from God. So when man sinned, his relationship was cut off. But we need to reach out to them so that we can bring them back to God, so that the friendship we have and God can be able to come back. Will you be able to do that? That is true. Number two, after man has sinned, he became shameful. You just guess. You remember when you are standing like this in the mirror? When you go to the bathroom to face, can you walk when you look at you like this? Can you be able to do that? Of course, you'll be ashamed. Can you move out with your toilet and you go to school? Of course, no. You'll not be able to do it. So if you do so, you'll be ashamed. So man was ashamed. So those boys and girls out there, they're ashamed. They cannot be able to see that they can be able to move near God. So they're ashamed of themselves. So we want to go and encourage them so that they can come back to God. All right? That is one of the things why we want to go and talk about them out there. All right, that is very interesting, and that's very good. What you have to think about, have you thought about it? Have you been lonely? Have you been left alone? That if you have been left alone, this is the time for you to come together and bring those people back to God. That is why we must reach out there and bring them back to God. That is you and me. That is our opportunity and the reason to do it so much. And that will be an amazing thing. Would you be able to miss about it? Of course not yet. And it will be able to be there. And the third thing that we must be able to talk about is man was chased out of the Garden of Eden. Remember, God was given an opportunity. Just imagine if dad and mommy has chased you out of your bed, have chased you out of the good thing that you have been able to do, and you miss it. You can imagine, man was chased out of the Garden of Eden, and every good thing that the man had, lost it all. Will you be able to lose it? So we want to bring these children back that can be able to be welcome into God's kingdom. Okay, that's an amazing one, and I believe we can be able to do it. So we want to remind ourselves about the three things we have talked about. The first one, man was separated from God. His relationship with God was done completely. Number two, shame or fear came upon the man. So he came trembling and he was wondering. You see, have you ever been scared with something? So the person gets scared and started being frightened and getting excited. That's what happened. And number three, you see, man was chased out of the Garden of Eden. Would you like to know what happened next after man has been chased away from the Garden of Eden? Please, don't dare miss for the next Sunday. All right, let's do our memory verse for today. Our memory verse is taken from the book of Romans chapter 3, verse 23. Everybody, are you there? Romans chapter 3, verse 23. It says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." Everybody, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That's our memory verse for the week. This week, I want to encourage you to be good boys and girls and think about those boys and girls out there who needs to be reached too. But the big thing we talked about today is sin. And remember the three things we talked about. May the Lord help you and give you the strength as this whole week as we plan and think about you. So see you next Sunday to know what happened after man had been chased out of the garden.